If the gap is there between, you may imagine what can be there inside. Even a dog can be there. If a boy can go there, a dog may also take shelter there, no? He braved all these things. What might be there? But I want that. I am to go there. So he went inside and slept over there the whole night. Slept means what? Is it a very, what we can say, peaceful one? No. Why? People go up and down that. And there will be cut, 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 cut. And lastly, he could able to take sleep. Morning, he had come out of that. He had seen all round. During the night, he did not see the place properly. But now he has seen it. What is there? There is a big ship. Means he is just at the adjacent road of a port where the metal is being unloaded from the ship. He could see some possibilities of earning some money. Right? And so he went to the ship. There he found an Englishman, a foreigner, that means a white person. And he talked to him, I want work. First of all, the captain, probably maybe a captain, he looked at him, you are too young to do certain thing. He said, no, I will do. What made the captain to agree? Only God knows. The captain agreed and had given the work of unloading the ship. He worked and he earned. He earned just enough for a breakfast. And he had a breakfast. And what he described in his book about that breakfast, you know, he had never forgotten that breakfast in his whole life. Why? If we are very thirsty, completely, the tongue has been parched completely, want water, right? And then I get some water, some. Earlier the same glass I have seen, it is half filled. Somebody must have drunk it halfway and he left it here. Why I should take that? Earlier I did that, but I left it. But if my thirst becomes more and more craving, then what happens? I will drink that. And that water, half glass of water becomes a nectar, I can say. The same way he earned that much of money for a breakfast, he took breakfast and he had come again back and talked to the captain, I will once again work. And the captain was good enough to keep him working for several days. Then he counted the money again once again. He could able to find, yes, this money is enough for me to seek admission into that school. And he bade a goodbye to that captain and he again once again started his journey towards Hampton. When he reached the school, the gate, from the outside itself he could able to find, yeah, into what heaven I am entering. That way. And he entered. Admissions are on. The principal is taking interview for the every boy. And he approached and he talked, I want admission into your school. The administrator has seen him from the toe to head, head to toe. Why? These many days walking, these many days not taking a bath and no change of cloth. Whatever he has put on, only that is there with him. And for all these days he was having that. And he is having mud in every part of his body. Plus his color. Color is not a problem over there because the school is for the colored people. Headmistress could not have faith on him. Did he continue? Does he continue? Would he continue? Could he continue? Many questions she brought. Let me see. Then she said, hello, there is a room over there. It is called as a recitation room. There are n number of benches over there. There is a furniture. It has not been cleaned. Would you mind cleaning it? He said, yes, I'll do it. He took the broom and went there and started sweeping, dusting. He took a cloth, cleaning, and he does it for at least 7 to 8 times, each and every piece of furniture, each and every door, each and every rod to the windows, each and every arch for the walls, wheresoever it is there. Everything he had cleaned and then reported, yes ma'am, it is ready. That lady was so, what we can say, is a very shrewd, we can say, when it comes to the work and examination. She examined every piece of furniture. First of all, she put the finger, no dust. Then she took out her white and very fair pocket rumal, that is handkerchief, and with that also she has done everywhere. Nowhere she could able to get the dust. Then she could able to understand, yes, this is the boy. He wants it, and he has shown that he wants it. How can you say, sir, because he has swept over there, that he wants to study? Yes, when a man is determined, convicted, it is called conviction, I want to, then he does miracles, he does everything with the same zeal. If I want to be educated, I will see that the work given to me is completed. Nobody should point out a finger. Then she liked him and she admitted him into that school. Later, much later, when he had been graduated, he says that he did not forget three things. The place where he slept in Richmond. And after, when he had become a great personality, people have brought him, called him, and just in front of that place only, they have arranged a felicitating meeting over there, just in front of that. And he pointed out, the night when I have slept over there, still I remember it. First one. Second, the breakfast which he took the next day after earning money, he did not forget that. And during his studies, he had faced many examinations, many tests. And he says, the admission test is the best test whatsoever I have attended so far. That is a great personality who cannot simply forget the place from where he had come. Right? So, about him, in his own words, we are going to read the struggle, his struggle for an education. That is there in our lesson. I will read the lesson and we will see the grammatical points over there, because much of the grammar we are learning, and with that also we are learning this lesson. One day, while at work in the coal mines, I happened to overhear two miners talking about a great school for colored people somewhere in Virginia. This was the first time that I had ever heard anything about any kind of school or college that was more pretentious than the little colored school in our town. I had one tell the other that Not only was the school established for the members of my race, but that opportunities were provided by which poor but worthy students could work out all or a part of the cost of board. And at the same time, he taught some trade or industry. Sometimes we taught some trade or industry. I resolved at once to go to that school, although I had no idea where it was or how many miles away or how I was going to reach it. I remembered only that I was on first constantly with one ambition, and that was to go to Hampton. I was on fire constantly with one ambition, and that was to go to Hampton. While at work, there I heard of a vacant position in the household of General Louis Ruffner, the owner of the salt furnace and coal mines. Mother applied to her for the vacant position. I was hired at a salary of $5 per month. I soon began to learn that first of all, she wanted everything kept clean about her, that she wanted things done promptly and systematically, and that at the bottom of everything, she wanted absolute honesty and frankness. Nothing must be slipshod, and every door, every fence must be kept in repair. Now, where was he working? He was working in a coal mine. And what did he hear? He heard that there is a school somewhere in Virginia. Does he know where is it? No, he doesn't know where it is. Then, simply he heard. And what is the quality of the school? The school is purely for this kind of people. And it may compensate the costs with working. It may compensate costs with the working. So he wanted that kind of a thing only. And do you mean to say there is no school in this area? There is a school. And what kind of school it is? It is a school by name. Where do we know about it? Here we have, what is it one? That was more pretentious than the little colored school in our town. Now you see, here we have a school, but it is by name only. And we can say it is a school. That's all. But what I see and what I heard about it is much more than this school. Right? And this all he overheard. Overheard means somebody had come and told him no. Certain people were talking in between them. And luckily, he was there. He heard about it. Now, first sentence. One day, there you can see a comma. While at work in the coal mine, I happened to overhear two miners talking about a great school for colored people somewhere in Virginia. Why I took this sentence is, you can see certain connectors over there. While is a connector. Right? And we can see main clause and subordinate clause. While at work in the coal mine, that is a subordinate clause. Why? Because it is started with while. No, it doesn't give an independent meaning. It supports the meaning, but it doesn't give the complete meaning. That kind of clause is a subordinate clause and started with while. What is the main clause here? Main clause is, one day, I happened to overhear two miners. What were they doing? Talking about a great school for colored people somewhere in Virginia. Talking. It is also used as a conjunction there. What did he hear? He heard Minus talking. About what? About a school for whom? Colored. Where? In Virginia, somewhere. That way we have to analyze every sentence for the words. Then the understanding becomes easier. So, again, I heard one tell the other that not only was the school established for the members of my race, not only, and but that opportunities were provided by which poor but again worthy students could work out all for a part of the cost of board. Board means to be there and to eat and all these things, not this wooden board or blackboard or whiteboard. Boarding means to be put up there for, means residential, we can say. All the residential expenses he can square off by working, whether it is full or half. Now, I resolved, I determined, yes, this is the place where I am going to get admission into. That way, he resolved, means decided, or he has the conviction. Then, pakka irada jo hai, usko resolved bolte hain. Pakka irada, conviction, I have the conviction, I'll have to go and get the admission. Resolved. Now, let us see the other part. While at work here, I had a vacant position in the household of General Louis Rafna. He was working in the coal mines. And while he was there working, he could able to know that there is some vacancy, better job than this. What is it done? To work in a household of a general, Louis Rafna. Right? Means if he is a highly positioned man, right? He wanted the work, or his mistress wanted the work to be done in a very neat and clean manner.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.